Good morning students, in this video we will discuss another chapter of ecology, that is environmental issues. So environmental issues, mainly in this chapter we will discuss about pollution. Why we will discuss about pollution? Because there are an ever increasing rise in human population. It is putting equally demanding pressure in natural resources like air, water, soil, etc. Then when extra pressure exerted on natural resources like water, air, soil, then they undergo depletion and degradation. The depletion and degradation of all these natural resources, it results in pollution. So what is pollution? What is pollution? It is an undesirable changes in physical, chemical and biological characters of all these natural resources. It has potential that adversely affect human life, life of animals and human assets, etc. That is called pollution. And contamination is different from pollution. Contamination means it is the presence of harmful organism or presence of product of harmful organism which cause disease or discomfort for human beings and other animals. So pollution is the total undesirable changes. The undesirable changes in physical, chemical and biological characters of all natural resources. And contamination means it is the presence of only organism, the harmful organism, which cause disease or discomfort for human and other living organisms. And the chemicals or the factors which cause pollution, the chemicals or factors which cause pollution are called pollutants. They are called pollutants. So Environmental Act, usually Government of India is, it has prepared Environment Act for Protection in 1986. In 1986, so Government of India, it is enforced the environmental law. But the substances or the chemicals which cause pollution is called pollutants. And pollutants are usually two types, primary pollutants and secondary pollutants. Pollutants are of two types, primary and secondary. Primary pollutants and secondary pollutants. Pollutants are of two types, primary pollutants. Usually primary pollutants, they are existing in nature or they are existing in environment. For example, DDT, CO2, SO2, nitrogen oxides, etc. So these are the primary pollutants which cause pollution of various natural resources. And secondary pollutants, what are secondary pollutants? Secondary pollutants are formed due to reactions between two primary pollutants. For example, hydrocarbons and nitrogen oxides. These two are primary pollutants, and these two are, they are in the presence of light, they reacted to form ozone and peroxyacyl nitrate. Ozone and peroxyacyl nitrate, these two are secondary pollutants. Secondary pollutants are formed due to reactions between two primary pollutants. And the reactions between two primary pollutants require light. And secondary pollutants are also called photochemical oxidants. The reaction between hydrocarbons and nitrogen oxides in the presence of light to give ozone and peroxyacyl nitrate, they are secondary pollutants. Secondary pollutants are not existing in the environment. Only primary pollutants existing in the environment, and they cause pollution. Secondary pollutants are also cause pollution, but they are formed due to reactions between two primary pollutants. So here in this chapter we will discuss about pollution of air, pollution of soil, pollution of water, pollution of noise, different types of pollution. Initially, firstly, we will discuss about air pollution. Air pollution is control and protection. So we will discuss about air pollution. What is air pollution? The chemicals or the gases or other substances added to the atmosphere that has potential which adversely affect the human life, life of animals or human assets or etc. Or simply the pollutants which cause undesirable changes in physical, chemical, biological characters of air, that is called air pollution. Air pollution. And the pollutants and the substances which cause air pollution, they are called pollutants. Air pollutants. Air pollutants are also, they are used mainly two types. Primary air pollutants and secondary air pollutants. Primary air pollutants and secondary air pollutants. Initially we will discuss about primary air pollutants. So there are different types of primary air pollutants. Particulate matter, next carbon dioxide, hydrocarbons, sulfur oxides, nitrogen oxides, chlorofluorocarbons, different types of, there are primary air pollutants. And the first or very important primary air pollutant is particulate matter. So what is particulate matter? Particulate matter consists of soot and fly ash. So what is soot? Fly ash and different types of dust particles. What is soot? It is unburnt carbohydrates. Unburnt carbohydrates are called soot. And fly ash, so they are the product of due to combustion of various fossil fuels, and there are some dust particles. Usually particulate matter is divided into two types, settleable and suspended. Particulate matter, again it is of two types, settleable and suspended. It is of two types. Settleable means the particles of particulate matter, the size of settleable particulate matter is more than 10 micrometers. The size of settleable particulate matter is more than 10 micrometers. Usually they exist in the environment for more than 1 day. They do not cause any harmful effects in human life. And next, suspended particulate matter, it is also called SPM, suspended particulate matter. The size of suspended particulate matter is 10 micrometers. Usually they existing in the environment for few days to several weeks. And according to CPCB, Central Pollution Control Board, 2.5 micrometers or less than 2.5 micrometer size of SPM, it causes various respiratory discomforts in the human beings. It is very important point. According to CPCB, Central Pollution Control Board, 2.5 micrometers or less its diameter, which cause various respiratory disorders in the human beings. So it is the particulate matter. The first air primary air pollutant is particulate matter. And second one is carbon monoxide. Generally, carbon monoxide, it is released due to incomplete combustion. The second one is carbon monoxide. So carbon monoxide, it is released due to incomplete combustion. And usually carbon monoxide, it has residency in the atmosphere. And cigarette smoke also contain carbon monoxide. And usually carbon monoxide combines with hemoglobin to form carboxyhemoglobin, which impair the transport of oxygen in the blood. And next one is carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide, usually it is greenhouse gas. Initially it does not act as pollutant, but when the concentration of CO2 increases, then it acts as primary air pollutant, which causes undesirable changes in the air. And next, hydrocarbons. So hydrocarbons are naturally, they are formed, and majority of the hydrocarbons are carcinogens. Majority of the hydrocarbons are carcinogens, and they also release due to incomplete combustion. And there are some another primary air pollutant, sulfur oxides, nitrogen oxides, chlorofluorocarbons. These are also some of the primary air pollutants which cause undesirable changes in the physical, chemical and biological characters of air, which cause air pollution. Next, secondary air pollutants. Next one is secondary air pollutants. Usually secondary air pollutants they are released due to chemical reactions, photochemical reactions between two primary air pollutants, hence they are called photochemical oxidants. Secondary air pollutants are also called photochemical oxidants, and all these photochemical oxidants, they are present in a special form of smoke. What is smoke? It is opaque or dark fog having water vapor, dust particles and other gases, that is called smoke. And smoke is of different types of classical smoke and photochemical smoke. Classical smoke is also called London smoke, and second one is photochemical smoke. And some of the secondary air pollutants are some of the pollen grains, spores and ozone, peroxyacyl nitrate. These are the some important secondary air pollutants which cause pollution of air. And here, pollution in urban areas mainly due to automobiles. Pollution in urban areas is mainly automobiles, and these automobiles inefficiently burn petroleum and diesel to cause 70% of noise pollution, 70% of noise pollution and 80% of air pollution, which was caused by automobiles. Automobiles are the main reason for air pollution in urban areas. Generally, the automobiles or vehicles, they inefficiently burn petroleum and diesel to release large number of primary air pollutants which cause pollution. And 70% noise pollution is due to automobiles, and 80% air pollution is due to automobiles. In this, 52% of air pollution is due to carbon monoxide, and 18% is due to carbon dioxide. 10% is due to hydrocarbons, and 6% is due to nitrogen oxides, and 2% of air pollution, the remaining pollutants. Now we will discuss how to control air pollution. Control of air pollution. Control of air pollution is achieved by use of low sulfur fossil fuels. Next, reduction in emission of effluents. Next, zoning of industries away from human settlements and fixed or used by catalytic converter. So if you fix catalytic converters to automobiles, then they efficiently burn the different primary air pollutants to release very less number of air pollutants. So these are the some of the methods to control the air pollution. And if you control the air pollution, mainly you should control the particulate matter. So how we control the particulate matter? So control of particulate matter is carried out by two important is SPM, suspended particulate matter. How to control suspended particulate matter? So it is carried out by two different types of devices used to control particulate pollutants. And they are two important devices are they are arresters and scrubbers. If you observe the NCERT textbook, there is one diagram for arrester and one diagram for scrubber. First, we will discuss about arresters. So what are arresters? They are the devices to remove particulate matter from the dust or from the dirty air. There are different types of arresters. Some important types are, first one is साइक्लोनिक अरेस्टर्स. इन साइक्लोनिक अरेस्टर्स व्हेन द डर्टी एयर इज पास्ड इनटू अ चैम्बर व्हेन लाइक दिस वन. So if you think this is a cyclonic arrestor, when the dirty air passes into a chamber where it is rotated, then the centrifugal forces cause the settling down of particles and the clean air is allowed to pass out. This is the cyclonic arrestors. And second one is. Gravity settling chambers. Here it is a large size chamber where dirty air passed, then heavier particles settle down and clean air is allowed to pass out. And the most important, that is electrostatic precipitator. So electrostatic precipitator is like this one. It is the diagram for electrostatic precipitator. These are the electrically charged collection plates and these are dust particles, various dust particles, and these are some of the particles, they are negatively charged. This is collection plates. They are grounded to the earth and this is the corona of negative charge and they are the dust particles. And these electrostatic precipitators are the most efficient devices where particles are electrically charged, where dust particles are electrically charged to form a corona of negative charges around them. Here in this device, the dust particles, the particulate matter which is present in dirty air, they are electrically charged. When they are electrically charged, they form corona of negative charges around them. When these particles are allowed to pass, when these particles are passed through these collection plates, then they lost these negative charges. And particles are settled down and clean air is allowed to pass out. So ultimately, these arrestors helps to remove the particulate pollutants from the dirty air, and obviously it helps in the increase the quality of air. And next one is scrubbers. So scrubbers are also devices to remove dry or wet pollutants from the industries. So these are the two important devices to remove the pollutants from the dirty air or particulate rich air. So here electrostatic precipitator is very important. So already I told you, in urban areas the air pollution is mainly due to automobiles. In automobiles generally two-stroke engine usually fitted to two-wheelers. But here it has to be changed, four-stroke engine to the two-wheelers or to fit catalytic converters. Then they does not release much more of primary air pollutants, or use of unleaded petrol or diesel. When unleaded petrol and diesel used, they release very less amount of sulfur fossil fuels. Or to fix catalytic converters. When you fix catalytic converters to the automobiles or vehicles, then these catalytic converters usually they contain costly metals like platinum, palladium and rhodium, and these costly metals, they act as catalysts. Usually they act as catalyst. When they act as catalyst, then these catalytic converters convert unburned hydrocarbons, they are oxidized to form carbon dioxide. Similarly, carbon monoxide also catalyzed or oxidized into carbon dioxide. And similarly, nitrogen oxides, they are split to form nitrogen gas. And these are the not that much of potential to adversely affect the human life. So that's why the catalytic converters are very important to remove the primary air pollutants from the automobiles. So the vehicles which are fixed with catalytic converter, they should use unleaded petrol or diesel, because leaded petrol or diesel, it active the catalyst of the vehicle. That's why catalytic converters, the vehicles which are fixed with catalytic converters, they should use unleaded petrol or diesel. So this is the air pollution and its control. Now we will discuss control of vehicular pollution. It is a case study. The case study about air pollution. Control of vehicular pollution or automobile pollution. Case study. It is one of the case study for air pollution. So if you observe Delhi, capital city of India. Delhi has the maximum vehicles. In 1990, the total number of cars in Delhi is more than the combined number of cars Gujarat and West Bengal. In 1990, the total number of cars were more than the combined number of cars in the states of Gujarat and West Bengal. And Delhi is used to rank 4 amongst 41 most air polluted cities. In India, Delhi is the most air polluted city, and Linfen, it is the city of China, it is the most air polluted city in the world. But Delhi, in 1990, Delhi is used to rank 4 amongst 41 air polluted cities in the world. And most of the people of Delhi, they are complaining burning of eyes and some of the respiratory discomforts. Now, a public interest litigation bill, it was filed in Supreme Court. Then Supreme Court has measured, or it is released some of the instructions to government to take appropriate measures to reduce the air pollution through switching off public transport from petrol or diesel to compressed natural gas. Generally, the public transport vehicles, usually they use petrol or diesel for their running. But instead of petrol or diesel, so Supreme Court has produced some of the normalities or regulations to use CNG. Second one is phasing out of old vehicles. And next one is to reduce or to use unleaded petrol or diesel. So for these methods, the air quality of Delhi has improved to substantial fall of carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, sulfur oxides and nitrogen oxides. And Delhi is the first city in the world to use CNG for its public transport. And CNG is better than petrol or diesel, because this is very important for 2 marks. CNG, compressed natural gas. CNG is better than petrol and diesel, because it is cheaper and it is efficiently burned to release less number of pollutants and it is it does not or it cannot siphoned off by thieves, and it is not adulterated like petrol and diesel. So that's why compressed natural gas is more efficient than petrol and diesel. So to mention the above adaptations, so Delhi, the air quality of Delhi has improved to substantial fall in sulfur oxides, carbon dioxide and nitrogen oxides. But here the problem is CNG, laying of CNG pipelines, laying down of CNG pipelines, it is not possible to every condition, because CNG is not available in everywhere. So that's why Government of India has formulated a new fuel policy. So according to this one, or according to Euro 2 norms or Bharat Stage 2, the sulfur content of petrol should not more than 150 ppm, and the sulfur content of diesel, it should not more than 350 ppm. And 1st April 2005, and Euro 2 norms applicable for throughout the India. And initially, before 1st April 2005, the Euro 2 norms applicable for 11 cities in India. So 11 cities: Ahmedabad, Surat, Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai, Hyderabad. So these Ahmedabad, some of the 11 cities. In 11 cities, Euro 2 norms are applicable. But 1st April 2005, the norms of Euro 2 applicable to throughout the country. But at the same time, Euro 3 norms, they are applicable to the 11 cities of India. From 1st April 2010, and Euro 4 norms applicable to 11 cities, and Euro 3 norms applicable rest of the India. Now it is Euro 6 or Bharat Stage 6, BS6. Now it is BS6. And according to Euro 4 norms, 35 ppm should not be more than sulfur content. The sulfur content should not be 35 ppm in diesel and 50 ppm in petrol. So when you adopted these kind of adaptations, then the air quality of any cities has improved to substantial fall of various primary air pollutants. So this is the case study for control of vehicular pollution.